Just the one change for Australia's eighth international this year. Apia defender Darren Stewart has been promoted for Andrew Marth, who's out because of business commitments. For 26-year-old Stewart, tonight he makes his long-awaited debut. Coach Scheinflug has opted for stability rather than experimentation. Two changes for Croatia in this their second international since being readmitted to FIFA. Number 17, 21-year-old attacking midfielder Robert Spehar gets his chance to impress. And number 14 central defender Dubravko Pavličić has also been promoted. Of the touring party, Goran Vucevic is the most highly rated, and he's been the target of a $5 million offer from Barcelona. And FIFA-appointed referee Tom McCrow gets us underway here at Hindmarsh Stadium for the second international of a three-match series between the Socceroos and, of course, Croatia, who were recently readmitted to FIFA. And this is their second international under their banner as a FIFA competitor. Already the referee has pulled up play for the infringement. And the number six, Bilic, the tall central defender, is the culprit on this occasion. Sadly, inclement weather in Adelaide today and yesterday has put a bit of a downer on what we hoped would have been a good crowd. But the Socceroos have the job in front of them this year with the World Cup qualifiers as Tapai tries to get his shot on the target and the good covering work. The Socceroos have obviously picked up exactly from where they left off in Melbourne. That was a similar start for Australia, Peter Katholis.
Great start, Andy. Great start for Australia. Good shot there by Tapai. Unfortunately, it was blocked away, but great conditions tonight for soccer. We should see a good game.
As per usual, Mike Peterson takes the corner. Mishy heads the ball away. And possibly the Croatian counter looked like it was on, but Paul Wade picks up the pieces in the midfield. Peterson with a pass on. They were all onside. And again, Polak is in there heavily involved in the play. But now Croatia can get things started. Speha was the man who played the ball square across to Romic. Good skills by the right back. But he ran into the ability and the capabilities really of Ernie Tapai have been a revelation as Eddie Thompson has sung his praises. But Van Blerk, who's filling in at that left defensive attacking role, you could say for Australia was heavily involved in the play. But it promises to be an open game. Obviously for Australia's sake, with the World Cup qualifiers around the corner, Peter, that Coach Scheinflug and, of course, his assistant Raul Blanco have decided today to stick by those same players, except, of course, Andrew Marth's work commitments wouldn't allow him to be here today.
Yeah, it looks like we've stuck to a lineup to get the same lineup as overseas, what they've used to get a lot of play involved.
So Mike Peterson, who's looking for Durakovic, who was onside, and that would have fallen favourably for Memon Durakovic, but Tom McCrow has pulled up play for a late challenge on Mike Peterson. And Tom McCrow, of course, appointed to the FIFA panel this year. This is his second international, by the way. It was just at this same venue when he controlled the fixture between Australia and Sweden. And that was the last international here, and of course that finished in favour of the Socceroos, 1-0. Superb finish from Alistair Edwards. Alex Tobin on familiar territory as Peterson gets it across to Darren Stewart, the debutant. Ivanovic, one of three in the defence with the champions of the Cup winners, Adelaide City. Finds his man in Van Blerk. There's runners in the box in Spink and Polak if he wants them. Van Blerk with a low cross this time for Tapai. And now Spink, can he get the shot on? He drives and straight to the keeper. The keeper was well positioned. But a superb start by the Socceroos. We've had 3 minutes of play and already two attempts at goal. One was blocked by Tapai, that time Spink.
Great play by Australia there, Andy. I mean, Van Blerk taking the player on down the side. I think he's going to be used more and more in this game. And the conditions are certainly will suit Australia tonight.
Now Bilic. Mishy. Nice skills. Vucevic is the man. And a good sweeping ball across for Romic. Got some numbers in the box if they want them. In comes the cross. Zabika as cool as ever at the back.
It's the first time we've seen him come forward, Andy. It's a great move. Vucevic, good skill there. A great ball down wide.
Polak. Now Spink. A lone hand at the moment. Well, was he clipped back? The referee says yes. Bavličić has committed the offence in a very good position for Australia. Miche is the man who's talking to referee Tom McRae at the moment. Obviously, not too happy with some of the challenges, but it's been a committed start from both teams. We've had just on 8 minutes of play, and both teams eager to get into attacking situations. And it's a really enterprising start, one that we've been thoroughly impressed with. Will it be Peterson? And remember, Jurakovic can strike a ball from here. And Nedzelic out there to also try his luck. It looks like Peterson. Well, will he play it to the left for Alex Tobin, who's free, or will he go himself?
So Peterson will have a go.
Peterson lines it up into the wall, though. Wade is across there for Australia. He's got Jurakovic, but he opts for Stewart. Stewart getting around his man. He can't keep it in, though. The covering work are coming from Stimac, the tall midfielder. Bilic, he's 23 years of age, he's with Hajduk Split, he leaves it for Biskup. Back with Biskup again, inside for Miche. Miche looks up for the runners, Vucevic is there. Good dart inside, challenger coming from Peterson. Now Jurakovic, he had to head it away. There wasn't really a call, I don't think, from his keeper, but there's no worries at all at the back for the Socceroos now. As we approach the 10-minute mark. Now Stewart. Had a brief chat to Darren Stewart before the game, and he looked like a bit of a bundle of nerves, surprisingly, but then again, it is your Socceroo debut, and now the Socceroos could possibly do something here. Speak inside for Tapai, a goal for Australia! 1-0, 10 minutes in, and what a great move started by Jason van Blerk.
What a great goal there, great passage of play, knocking the ball around, just cut it across the box, and there's Tapai to put it away.
Ernie Tapai, his first goal at full international level. Van Blerk combined with Spink. It was a good ball inside. Tapai with a right footer beating Ladic. 1-0 Australia. And Peter Katholos, that is a stunning start, really. Australia have really taken the game. I'm not saying that I'm surprised, but it's been a great start by Australia. Positive in all aspects.
Yes, absolutely, Andy. We look very positive. We're knocking the ball well. Great passage of play there, knocking play the 1-2, the through ball by Van Blerkie. And that was a great goal, great finish by Tapai.
And there's the replay again. Van Blerk with a great ball inside. Spink was onside, and he slotted it back. And Tapai, a great finish.
Great finish there.
And that was the only way to go, although the keeper had to backpedal a bit as the clearance back to his keeper from Bilic for one brief moment appeared to possibly test Ladic. Australia are leading by 1-0. Miche. He rode the challenge of Wade, but Van Blerk gets it back. And there's certainly no quarters given out there. Very physical confrontation, you could say. No one holding back in the challenges. Ivanovic. And what a situation it is for Australian football to have the likes of Zelic and Ivanovic vying for the sweeper's role. Of course, Zelic has played in the midfield in recent matches during the Tour of the Americas. Tapai, so nimble-footed. He's maintained that great form of the Americas as Wade was taken out late by Miche. Tapai for Jurakovic. Back for Tapai. Good play by Australia. Way, the captain, leading by example. The ball for Smith. He's onside. Can he get a pass to keeper? He can! Amazing! Australia are leading 2-0. 3 minutes gone. 13 minutes, rather, I should say. I can't believe the start by the Socceroos. A superb game from the Socceroos.
Fantastic goal there, Andy. Absolutely brilliant play. Great passage of one-touch football.
And the captain, who slotted it through for Spink, he rounded the keeper and slotted it away. His fifth goal in 14 internationals.
That's class.
Well, I hate to say it, but I think I've got to catch my breath today. This is... been one of the best starts by an Australian team in, well, I can't really recall, but Spink, what a quality finish. Ivanovic inside now to Peterson, and surrounded by three of the players of Croatia. Miche was the man who lunged for the ball. Zabica, I think his third touch in the game. Stimac was hoping to get a bit of a flow going there. Yet another stoppage. There's been quite a few in the game. 2 goals, Australia lead against Croatia in the second match here at Hindmarsh Stadium. And there's plenty of Socceroos support there, but Ivanovic in the end keeps his cool at the back. And just plays it on for Alex Tobin. Much was said about the first game in Melbourne. The Croatia coach was disappointed by the media's thoughts on the game because it was a pretty physically active encounter first up. Miche has looked up for support. And a great run, but in the end it was just too difficult.
See a substitute warming up already. His coach definitely is not happy.
And yet another late lunging challenge, and it looks like Stimac just trying to pick the number. It's very difficult to pick the number on the Croatian shirts, as I'm sure most of you at home would gather.
Bilic was the offender there.
Vucevic, it appears, has gone in the book. As Polak did his best to try and control it. Romic at the back. Miche kept his cool ever so well. Vucevic the back here. Nice play. Bilic. And he was taken out by Stewart. Stewart will go on the book. Although Bilic did milk it for all it's worth. Bilic was there and Stewart would come in.
Oh, it's a professional foul there. I mean, yeah.
Pretty physical encounter, Peter. Not one that we didn't expect really after the first game in Melbourne.
Well, I think they're looking for a big game. They were looking to win this game, and being 2-0 down in, you know, in the first 20 minutes of the game, it's a bit embarrassing for them.
And what a great steal by Paul Wade, the captain, leading by example. Tap by inside. Peterson has a bit of room ahead of him. He'll look for Spink or Polak. There's the ball for Spink. And Romic didn't really clear it away properly. Polak again. Van Bloek on his left. There's numbers in the box if Van Bloek can get it across. He does get it across. And thankfully for Croatia, Bilic was the man who got it away. Although the pressure is right on them at the moment. Although Tapai found it extremely difficult to control. Bilic again, always looking to break from the back. Speckard also, the 17 for Croatia, is Wade. And Paul Wade having a top game again in the middle of the park for Australia.
Absolutely, Andy. He's running up and down, and he's controlling really the player there. He's leading by example.
Ivanovic's ball inside. A rare mistake, although Stimac couldn't take advantage of the situation. Peterson inside. Ivanovic. Van Blerk. Polak. And the referee says he was also fouled. Yet another stoppage. We've only had 23 minutes. So as the light rain comes down at Hindmarsh, Polak. And this time again, Miche. Well, I think we've almost reached 20 stoppages in the game. Yes, 23 minutes in. And you'd be surprised, really, considering there are two goals up. As the referee allowed play to continue, Blurk's cross was blocked. And he does well to get it back for Tapai. Tapai looks up. Inside is Wade. Ivanovic. Jurakovic. Intended to find Peterson. Tapai goes in pretty hard, and there's all sorts of skirmishes going out in the middle of the park. Wade is down, and three of the players are down. It looks like Modic is one of them. And yet another infringement. Well, the referee will hold up play. I'm trying to work out exactly which player it was. He's obstructed from our view.
Well, these slippery conditions don't help. I mean, these late tackles coming in. Players are always going to get injured.
And you'll see as the ball came in, Tapai came in a bit late, and
the guy's stepping all over him.
Well, Paul Wade had a bit of fun and games out in the middle as well, and he really, Paul Wade certainly felt the brunt of a late challenge there. We're all keeping our eye on the effects of the challenge on Romic. We'll have another look at this replay here.
Oh,
Tapai came in late. Wade's on the ground there. The Socceroo captain. Copped a bit of a knee in the head, and another kick there. Three or four times, and it was Stimac the culprit. So it's one thing that it's difficult for Tom McCrow to pick up in the back play. Stewart's. His ball was cut out by Stimac. The shots went through the legs of Stewart. Zabika had it covered. Vucevic, the first time we've seen him really try one on the Socceroos goal, and Zabika, of course, had it covered again. 25 minutes in. Still 2-0 to Australia. Two goals coming the first 13 minutes of play.
Vucevic is playing, Andy, a free role just behind the fours there, and he seems to be getting a lot of room, and he's probably the most dangerous player for Croatia. We've got to watch him.
The Croatians really haven't tested Zabika as much as we thought they would, but you've got to pay credit to the home team. It's no real bias. Australia are playing well.
They're playing very well. Especially after the tour to South America. I mean, it's done them a lot of good. They look very composed out there.
I don't know why there's so many late challenges coming in, and you don't want to point the gun at anyone, but Croatia have been pulled up for more of those challenges than the Australian Socceroos.
Well, when you're losing, it's very frustrating, and I think a lot of frustration is creeping into their game. Again, I think it's an embarrassment for them to be 2-0 down at this stage of the game.
Let's just hope that nothing ugly eventuates out in the middle.
Sure.
Australia have struggled to score goals this season. Alistair Edwards and Paul Wade put away Australia's goals in a three-match series against Sweden.
It's a great
challenge. And now a great challenge to come in. Spink Dragovic is on his right. He slid it through for Tapai. Tapai, the keeper. Good save by the keeper. Came off his line quickly. Dragovic, I thought, was perhaps the better option. But Australia could have been three up, and it's only 27 minutes in.
It just delayed us slightly. If that was a little bit earlier, I think it could have been another goal for Australia there.
Tapai to Wade. Stewart. He looks up for the runner and decides against it for Polak. This time, Peterson leaves it for Spink. Great turn by Spink. Polak's on his right if he wants it. Polak finding it tough to get through this Croatian defence. Nice back heel from Miche. Getting it back inside for the sweeper, Jerker. He's looking up for support. Vucevic. And Biskup switching across. Better possessional play from the Croatian team. This is more like it that we've come to expect. Miche. Bilic. Is in the box and the shot, and Zabika does well to save. A mad scramble and it's stuck away. The comeback goal from Weber, 31 minutes in. The first real threat of the Australian goal, and Croatia hit back. Weber, the man who's brought the game back for Croatia. He was the leading scorer in the Belgian First Division with Cercle Bruges, and it took the brilliance of Weber.
Well, here they
the
show
commitment.
Here they show their European class, really, Andy. They put a lot of passage of play before this result came in. A lot of passage of play, a lot of one-touch football, and they really show their European class.
Croatia certainly in the last 10 minutes played a dominating role in this game.
Yeah, they certainly picked up their tempo.
Very slow start, surprising. That really surprised all of us in the ground here at Omar Stadium in Adelaide.
I think they'll wake up after the two goals.
And as you noticed, it could have been three down. Ivanovic. Such an elegant player on the ball, Stewart. He recovered well after slipping.
Great ball.
Now Dragovic too. Yes, I thought it was just too much for him. Right idea. Plenty of room to play for. There was no one there covering. Jerker gets it. Next Hagel boy. He's in Spain. One of the best sweepers over there. Play with big wraps, Polak. Miche chasing. Now Ivanovic again lunging down, and Australia have some deficiencies of late. Some uncharacteristic errors. They've been caught out. As Croatia have moved quickly to attack now, Australia can do the same. Tapai was pressured by Bilic. Kavicic to Weber. Weber now. Well, he's gone solo instead. The man was free on his right, and Weber went on with it too long. And he should have played it across. They'll get a corner, though. Weber remonstrating with his teammates. But really, with 1.5 minutes of normal time left, he had a free man on his right in Speker.
Thank God he didn't play that ball wide. Otherwise, we could have been another goal.
Keeping it close. No worries at all for the Socceroo keeper.
Well, they certainly look very dangerous when they come forward. They come running direct at players, and they look very, very effective when they come forward.
Yes, they certainly did. Get it. A release of life after that goal as Polak does his best to get away from Jurgen. The referee was playing the advantage rule, and there wasn't really much of an advantage as you saw. So now Australia, we haven't seen them in this situation in quite a long while. The first 30 minutes, Australia just kept on peppering the Croatian goal. An early tap by put Australia ahead in the 10th, leaves it for Peterson. Plenty of Croatian cover. Now Van Bloek looking, trying to get it through, and there's Spink. He hesitated. He should have gone first time, and it's hooked away by Jurgen. I really thought there that perhaps Spink would have been better off having a go at it first time. Lovely ball from Van Bloek.
Oh, yes, yes. First time shot would have been on target, would have been a good chance to put the third one away.
Captain Ludic, the goalkeeper, demanding that certain players be picked up. And a lot of deep players for the Socceroos. In it comes from Peterson. And Wade was up there as well. And that is, in fact, it at half-time. So Australia almost grabbing yet another goal. Well, what a first half it's been. Australia had broken through in the 10th through Tapai. Then Spink in the 13th. Then Croatia fought their way back into the match. Weber got it back to 2-1 in the 31st. So a half-time scoreline here at Hindmarsh. Australia 2, Croatia 1. So it's been just over 100 years since they practice football matches in Zagreb. The Croatian young men before them, in the 1870s, English football was played by Hungarian railway men in the Croatian city of Rijeka. So it's all led to this, Croatia's readmitted to FIFA and their clashes with Australia, their second international today since they were readmitted to FIFA. And what a first half it was here at the Hindmarsh Stadium in Adelaide. Australia had taken a great lead. After just 13 minutes, they led by two goals. Then Croatia fought back in typical fashion as that lovely sweeping ball on that left-hand side, although you've got to pay credit to Darren Stewart. Now Tapai was looking down the line for Polak, and Ernik Tapai's had a great game today for Australia. Spink leaves it for Wade. On the left is Van Bloek. Now Spink makes his run through the centre. That's a good ball for Spink. The flag's up though. Touch and go.
A very late decision there by the linesman.
Now Stimac is on the right if Speckard wants him. And a good lunging challenge from Ivanovic. And he's so cool on the ball. Such an elegant player at the back, and he's so safe as well. Former Red Star Belgrade player just finds his man in Polak. There's numbers square. Tapai has Jurakovic. Wasn't strong enough. It comes off Jurakovic though.
That was a great intercept by Ivanovic there. Could have been a big chance for Croatia.
Now it looks like the substitute had gone for the ball, Vlahovic. And it's back inside with the playmaker, Vucevic. Bilic again, one of those sweeping runs on the left-hand side. Keeping an eye on him is Ernie Tapai, and he concedes the corner. And they looked fairly dangerous in those corner kicks in the first half, Croatia. Couple of occasions where the soccer defence has been a bit touchy.
Well, they look more comfortable on the ball, look more confident, and they're coming forward. Good runs off the ball, and Australia should be very, very careful.
And it comes again, and Stewart was there for Australia. Peterson is nudging it on for Polak, too strong for him. Jurgen though gives it straight back. Van Bloek has come across from the left. Wade's offside and he tried to get it on for Spink. He'll get it to him though. Good jinking turn inside by Spink, and that's a yellow really in my books, considering I think really that Pavličić could consider himself somewhat lucky.
Great skill by Warren Spink there, taking two players on. He could have created a big chance there for Australia to come forward.
Ten minutes into this second half, Spink.
Let me see it again. Yeah, that's a professional foul there.
Yerkin across. The lunge came from Van Blerk. Coming away with it was the substitute Vlahovic. This time Wade gets back to help his defence. Tobin was thinking about his teammate from Adelaide City, Zabika or Ivanovic. Tap by it. This time the safety ball back to Robert Zabika. A different style of game in the second half, Peter. Not the open end-to-end that we were expecting, but it's a lot more thinking behind the play, particularly from Croatia.
Well, they're certainly coming forward, and they're coming forward intelligently. Short passing game, running off the ball. They look quite a good side when they come forward like that.
Well, Wade's headed it back towards his own goal. Stewart did away in the end, though. Now Peterson, good touch on. Well, he was kicked by Romic, and the referee was there. Right in front of the referee, it goes against Peterson now, I think.
Silly.
Well, unless Peterson was the instigator. And like we said, we're hoping there's not too many ugly incidents in the second half. Tom McCrae wants to say a few words for Mike Peterson. Trying to get the ball underway again. The referee won't allow play to continue until he's had a word to say to Mike Peterson, as much as it frustrates the Croatians.
Which is fair enough, he's in control, isn't he?
I think Tom McCrae's done his best to let the game flow, considering there's been some clumsy challenges, some late clumsy challenges.
He's had a good game. He's picked up on things that need to be picked up. Some late tackles out there, and he's done well.
Vucevic tried his best to feed it on to Pavličić. Wade just stuck it through, and geez, he's been fighting hard out there. It was Polak rather. Got back up on his feet now, away by Stewart. There's Wade now, and he did commit, I agree with the referee, a bit, perhaps a bit both ways, the shoulder to shoulder, but he's certainly done an exceptional job today, Paul Wade.
Again, he's run himself into the ground. He's up and down, and he's leading by example.
And he was saying before the game, he's thriving on the fact that he's been involved as a full-time player the last 10 months. Now, that's a yellow, if not maybe the red colour. And under the circumstances, considering some of the other challenges, that's gone according to what we've seen throughout the day. And it appeared that Spechard was the man who was booked.
Well, that's a silly tackle there. And the guy's on the run, he's on a break, and he brings him down.
Yes, it was Spechard. That's the third yellow of the game. Spechard was one of the two players that came into the game today. As you can see, really difficult to tell the players with the black on red, but...
Absolutely incredible.
Not as difficult as trying to recognise them before the game without the aid of an interpreter. But nonetheless, the Croatian contingent have enjoyed this. Enjoyed their stay in Australia so far.
I think white numbers would have been a lot better, Andy, don't you agree?
Either way, it's that's the way it is with their jerseys. Now Polak, Spink was calling for it, but he can't get it to him. Bilic just clipped. The referee allows play to continue. And the lunge had come in from Pavličić. A ball and all challenge. So a change to be made by Croatia and by Australia in the 26th minute. The number three for Croatia, Biskup, is off.
Number three, Krasnik Biskup, comes off. And going off is number 15, Niko Čeko.
Niko Čeko is the man coming on, the number 15. And Greg Brown has come on for Warren Spink. As Polak makes the desperate run down the right. Billich chased him down.
Well, I think Warren Spink has had a great game again. He's looked very, very sharp. He's given him a lot of trouble up front, and Les has probably given him a good rest to try Greg Brown.
Plenty of time left in this game. There'd be with, I would think, with the extra time that was added on because of the flares. About 20 minutes now, I would estimate, exactly left in this game. 2-1 Australia are leading. Coca-Cola Socceroos have been hanging on the second half under intense pressure as Polak copped a nasty challenge, really, from Čeko. And you'll see on replay, nowhere near the ball.
Well, that was a bad, bad kick.
So Polak assumes his position in the box. Peterson again will take the free kick. Tobin's come up from the deep and the header that skidded off Polak and evaded Tobin. And Brown had tried his best to keep it in. And perhaps that might have found Tobin at the back.
Yep, unlucky there. It's just a little bit too high. But great, great, great play there by Australia.
Yeah, this time Speckar knocked it straight back to his keeper to give his team a bit of a breather. Čeko. Stimac. Now Peterson, he slips and just gets it across. Đuraković.
Yeah, the slippery conditions haven't really helped both teams, and it's very, very difficult to control a very, very slippery ball. So that's why we're seeing a lot of mistakes from both sets of players out here.
Considering the conditions, it's not a bad display at all. And the referee has decided that he's not too happy with the place of... Yes, it looks like he's not happy with where Čeko took the throw-in, and he's decided. And Tapai back. Peterson. And again, another stoppage. And for the back chatting, that's what will eventuate. Stimac goes in the book, and I think he might have given him a red, Peter.
Oh, I didn't see that, any. I thought it was a yellow card.
Well,
unless he told him off there. Yes, he has. He sent him off.
Well, that's sensational. And I think there was confusion over the offence. Well, is it a yellow or is it a red? We'll have to double check with referee Tom McCrow. Stimac hasn't been booked in the game.
Yes, he's...
And Croatia have been reduced to 10 men. That's a red. Because it looked like Speckhardt had been booked in that second half.
I think he decided to walk off himself. I'm not sure what actually happened there. But he's given him a red card after he's walked from the bench and onwards.
Well, Croatia are down to 10 men. This is a similar situation to last week's game, Peter, when Jelicic was sent off. Well, what a turnaround it is now for Australia.
Yeah, well, we should take advantage now and really control the game from here.
Polak. back now for Peterson. Polak fighting hard with Pavličić. In the centre, the goal scorer Weber, they'll want a big performance from him. They're down to 10 men. Bilic across to Džeko. In comes the deep ball, and Zabica again will have no worries at all.
Yeah, I'd like to point out here, Andy, Jason Pollock looks very, very sharp playing in Europe and, you know, in the professional league there. Oh, there's the cross, and Zabiga catches it, no problem. Yeah, he looks very, very sharp, and he's a lot better player than when he left our shores here in Australia.
Again, Bilic, who's had a big role today. Weber trying to get it on again. Ivanovic went for it. The deep ball, Zabiga stays on his line. Van Bloem missed it, and so did Croatia in the end. Polak inside for Wade. Tap by now Peterson. The long ball now aiming for Brown. And away by Pavličić. And Jason Polak taken out by Pavličić.
Well, he's too quick for him there. He's beaten two of them. Great work there, Jason.
Van Bloek. Back inside for Brown. Clear shot at goal, and just wide from Greg Brown. He had plenty of time to think about it. Looked up, picked his spot, and for sadly, really, for Australia, shooting just wide.
That's unlucky there. Good shot at goal anyway, but that was good.
Wade. And Drakovic just lunges. And what a recovery from the Socceroo captain. As he says that every game he's playing for his shirt, he knows the pressure is right on. Not just for any player, but for the Socceroo captain as well. Jason Polak is rewarded with an early shower as well.
Yeah, I think Jason's done quite well. I mean, he's only played a couple of games now for Australia, but he's looked very, very sharp, and you know, he posed a big danger for the Croatian players in that first half.
So Tom McCullough comes on. This is his 10th international appearance, A international, of course. The deep ball comes in, Van Bloek's up, and he scores! What a goal from Jason Van Bloek! The keeper took it ever so easy, really, too casual. The deep ball from Tapai. Ernie Tapai heavily involved today in all of the goals. And Jason Van Bloek, he scored two goals against Indonesia B in his first game for Australia. This is his first goal at A international level. And that is virtually the ball game, Peter Katholis.
That's a great goal by Jason Van Bloek. Playing his first full international and scoring his first full international. I'm sure he won't forget that very quickly.
Australia leading 3-1 against Croatia in the second match at Hindmarsh Stadium in Adelaide.
Let's not forget, Andy, they're also, these players are full-time footballers, and you know, they're playing in the European League, and you know, it just goes to show, I mean, how highly rated we should be as far as a soccer nation now.
Look at Ivanovic, ever so cool on the ball. Wade, back to Van Bloek, dictating the game so much and so confidently. Bilic is a hard man to get through. And Ivanovic back to Tobin. He'll take it back to his keeper for sure. We're into the last five, Australia leading 3-1. It'll be mistake-free football from here on. Van Bloek.
Just looking at Jason also, I think he's given a new dimension to this team. He's a, you know, a wide man, left flanker. He can beat a player. He's got a good shot on him, put a good ball across. So he gives the Australian team another dimension in their play now.
Brown, and a lucky bounce back for him. across again for Van Blerk. Back inside for Brown. The shot's on. He's got it across for Tapai, releasing it for Jurakovic. Mehmet Jurakovic, one on one. And the keeper with a good save. Jurakovic will be very disappointed. It could have been his first international goal. And to be honest with you, I think it should have been.
Great chance here. Great chance. Unlucky there. Oh, Jesus. That was unlucky.
And Mehmet Jurakovic, who would have been celebrating as well. And there's just over 3 minutes of normal time left, and at the stoppages, for some of the flares that were thrown. And that work shot, that was on target as well. We saw a similar instance with Ivanovic in the first half. Pavličić was the man who banged into. And another change to be made. And it looks like Mike Grabowski is coming on for Peterson. Mike Grabowski. This is a debut as well for the Sydney Croatia defender. Wade, a rare mistake. Van Blerk. Brown. Now McCulloch. And Jurakovic again is left free on the right. In it comes, and almost an own goal, although Vadic was in a very good position. And he's certainly been under a constant barrage.
I think since the play got sent off, I think it's been one-way traffic here.
Now Tapai could get the return pass. He might, in fact, though, it's offside. We're just going through the motions, really, here at Hindmarsh Stadium, Australia. The Coca-Cola Socceroos leading Croatia by 3-1 in this second international of a three-match series. And that, in fact, will be it as Tom McGrath blows full-time. An impressive performance from Australia. The Coca-Cola Socceroos victorious again by 3-1.
Yes, I think this is a great performance, a great confidence booster for the games to come, the World Cup qualifiers, and playing against such a high opposition, I think they should be very, very proud of themselves.
So the final score here at Hindmarsh Stadium. The Coca-Cola Socceroos maintain their good run against Croatia, winning the second of a three-match series by 3-1.
What do you think the turning point was tonight, when when Stimic got sent off? Or, I mean, the Croatians seemed to be in the game, 2-1. But then when the play got sent off, things changed.
Yeah, well, I think the first 25 minutes we dominated and we let them in the game. And they maybe dominated for 20 minutes of the second half. And then I think we slowly started to get on top, and sure, the sending off helped. But I think we let him in the game.
How do you think players like Joseph Van Blerk, Darren Stewart fit into the side?
Magic. I mean, they played the game. We got a result, and at the end of the day, that's all that counts.
Hey, Eddie Thompson promised to be attacking football from the Socceroos. I mean, tonight, probably in the last four internationals, we saw more attacking than any of the four internationals.
Yeah, well, we had, a point to prove, and we haven't scored many goals of late. And, we've had plenty of chances. We created chances even overseas in that. And I'm telling you, it was one of those days that they came and we could have got more in the end.
You seem to be playing well in your soccer. Probably the move to Adelaide has sort of benefited your footballing career.
Oh, it helps when you play for a good team and you're out to not just make an appearance every week, but to try and win games. And the attitude towards the game is a little bit different, and sure, it's helped.
How do you think the game in Sydney will go on Sunday?
Well, and this is their last chance to show something to their loyal supporters, I guess. So I expect it to be just as hard, if not harder than tonight. And they'll come out firing.